Hello, today we'll discuss what testing is not because I thought this topic is important because on LinkedIn and everywhere you will see so many wrong things. So it's important to educate ourselves for what testing is not. So there may be some words coming in your mind regarding this. So let's see what's come at the end. So we'll do a case study. A very basic simple one. Suppose there is a requirement that on Google homepage for some days you want to add a text box where you will enter your year of birth. For example, if you enter 1990, then it should tell that you are 30 years of age, right? So if after this showing you this requirement, somebody asks this question that how much time will it take to test this requirement? So some people can quickly say that maybe 2 hours, 4 hours, 6 hours, 8 hours, or people can say even 3 days. So it depends that how much testing you want to do and what's the scope of it, right? But directly jumping to the estimate is not the right thing. There is something called as requirement analysis where you have to, even though it looks very simple, there are various angles involved to it. For example, in that text box, are we only allowing a number? Right? Is it if they are making it a drop down to avoid some problems because people can enter various kinds of input, and if there is a number, is there a limit about it, or do some risk analysis that whether it will impact any of the other functionalities that are present on the Google homepage because there are other things which are more important, right? And this functionality is also important, like for how many days it would be there. And Google has various regional sites as well. For example, for India, we have google.co.in or google.in. So whether it will be visible there as well or not, because that will decide your scope. And since it's there only for a few days, so we have to know that how many days are there and where we can configure, because those days are in future. So the testability part is important, that how people should not hard code that, right? So knowing that is an important part. So moving now comes the test estimate, and there are various ways of providing that. For example, some people use t-shirt sizing and playing poker, and it's more about the experience. If you have worked on a similar thing, you can tell that how much time it will take. And it's also relatively, for example, there are multiple user stories in a sprint, then you decide that that this is falling under small or medium based on what other user stories will take. So this is also an important activity similar to like we did requirement analysis, then we do test estimation, and then comes test planning. So yeah, the nowadays all these things overlap. Like it's not that the requirement analysis is gone and now you can't comment on requirement. You keep on doing that. So I'm just segregating it out, and there is nothing like it is step by step. It can overlap. So you will decide that which all tools you can use, what are the that who will do that, and when you will do that, and what kind of errors come, right? So there is a book where already there are 400 kinds of errors which are defined for various kind of things. For example, if a text box is there, what are the common errors that can come? So you need to have knowledge about all this, then you can plan better. And come the design phase after this. So since it's a text box where numbers can be added, like let's take that consideration for now. So I took this different input combination from a book called as Heuristics, right? Not the name of the book is Heuristic. There are various heuristics for various things that you can test. So these kind of scenarios, you would be forming positive, negative, accessibility testing, and there could be many kind of things. But this is a important phase where you decide that what you are going to test. Then comes the phase of execution, right? So here, there's an important part. So here you execute what you planned in the previous phase. For example, I might have come out with 20 scenarios that I would be doing. But in this, you will explore more. You will do exploratory testing, which is not done by machine, but by humans. That based on the previous experience they have, you will buddy test with developer. Buddy testing is like before you getting the actual build, you are sitting with developer and see that how the things have been implemented over there. And if there are basic bugs, then you can maybe remove those to save time. And then comes the test reporting, which you do on a daily basis. And in between, there is bugs also that you raise and how better you raise it, right? You can, different people with different years of experience and different knowledge, they raise it in a various different ways. So, but that's an important part. Test reporting is not just pass and fail, right? People can go to dashboard and they can take the data, but it's not that. There are stories linked with the numbers. Numbers, like if I say that 80 cases are passed out of 100, so it may give a good picture, but what if you have just done the low level scenarios, like low priority scenarios? Then that 80 is not useful for me, right? So that is important, and that comes with education. The more you more read about testing and all. So if you see, test is including all these activities. You do requirement, risk analysis, estimates, planning, designing, execution, reporting, and there could be some other things also that can be added over there. So it includes so many things. It's not. So what testing is not? So I'm coming to the conclusion of this, that testing is not automation. Test execution part, we automate generally, right? So there is nobody stopping you to estimate the testing estimate or test planning or even some part of designing, right? Or and there are no tools as of now, I know that, which can ask questions and do the estimates for you. You can design on your own based on your projects. Even if the tools will come, testing cannot be automated, right? It's not automatable. Test execution is. Tools are important. You should use the tools which can make your work easy. So you can ask me what's testing is. So there is a very good definition that has been given by James Buck, which states that it's learning about the product through evaluating, exploring, and which includes questioning, modeling, observation, right? And I would end with this, that pretty good testing is easy to do and excellent testing is quite hard to do. So with this, you can connect with me and we can teach each other about testing. And thanks for listening to me.